And we're live. How's everybody doing? Doing good? I'm doing fantastic. We're back again with part two. You guys were like, oh, these motherfuckers ain't gonna come back. We're back, like it or not. Part two.
What happened? Oh, jeez. I am buzzing it. Good evening. It's fucking Thursday.
Is it? It could be Thursday. It's Thursday today that we're recording it. Who knows when you're listening to it, but it is Thursday. In live moment.
Jesus. Oh. I'm not in the zone right now.
Not in the zone? Well, get okay. In the zone. Get in the zone.
So it's fucking August 7th,
2013. It is. No, it's the 8th. Is it the 8th? Oh, it is 8. 808. Oh, 808. It's the 808 drum.
2013.
It is 2013.
Fuck, tomorrow's payday for some people. I don't know. And other people don't get paid tomorrow. Fuck.
It just depends on when you get hired, you know? Most places is like every 2 weeks, right?
Some people get paid every week, so every week's payday. Lucky bastards.
Ah.
You know, other people it's every other week. Some people it's every month.
Yeah, like teachers every month.
Like government people.
I had a retail job. It was every week. It was cool, but the checks were like really small. Like it wasn't worth
that's
it.
True. That's true. I guess it's the same shit as when you get two checks. You know what I mean?
That's true, but it just you see the dollar amount more. You know what I mean?
I guess that is right. I mean, you every other week you're paying the same bills, so it's gone. But what up, everybody? How's it going
out here? This is not boring. We're being boring, talking about paychecks and stuff.
Oh, man, I'm talking about money.
Money. You get paid tomorrow?
Was it bands that make her dance?
Bands that make her dance? I don't know. That's some song like that, huh?
Fucking N-word song.
You get paid tomorrow?
Yeah, I get paid tomorrow. And gotta pay all these bills. Gotta pay for school.
Really?
School's
coming back up, huh?
Yeah, school.
The summer's over.
A lot of bitches.
Did you accomplish anything during the summer? Other than getting drunk and going to work?
I don't get drunk. I get
cool. You get on a sophisticated level?
Yeah. Visit some family and just work all summer. Put in overtime. What else? Hung out with my friends every now and then, every other week, more than I used to before summer. So school's coming up. That should be cool.
Did you already get your classes?
Already got my classes. That should be interesting.
What are you taking?
Books are expensive. You're an asshole.
Oh, yeah. Fuck books.
You're
dude.
An asshole if you buy your books new when you can just rent your books, all right?
Some people got money like that.
Yep.
Dude, these people.
And then that's exactly why you're an asshole, because you have $200, and you're like, I'm just gonna buy this new book. And then you could just rent it for like...
Oh, I'm just going to buy this new book. And they're going to put all fucking highlighter all over it.
You know, you can... Dude, let's see. One of my books was like $60. I rented it for like $15.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And then they pay for shipping, returning and
sending. Oh, they hooked you up, huh?
So, I mean, come on, really? And then what do you... You save money. You save the money and then you buy, I don't know, drugs and gas. Gas is a good one. Food... Because everyone loves to eat, right?
Of course.
And anything else, whatever people.
So did you get any good classes, or did you get a bunch of bullshit classes?
I got a lot of BS classes. I still need them somehow in my fucking two-year college career.
My college career. You should get my AA degree. We need to take bullshit 101.
I think out of those 30 classes, I only need like 10 or 15 of them. At 10 at most for my my field, but if they want the other 15, what can I do, right? So then after that, transfer out and do another 2 years of some other bullshit classes. But
boring.
That's what gets you paid. And the first ones to get paid are the first ones to get laid.
Oh shit.
Oh, God.
That was gross. Shouldn't have done that. Yeah. But anyways, summer's over. Did you go to the beach once? I didn't.
I did not. Did I?
Did you?
I went to the lake like twice.
Lake? Yeah. Oh, when you went to Arkansas?
Yeah, when I went to Arkansas, I went to the lake.
Is that like Lake Michigan or? What lake is that? I don't know. I don't fucking know. I don't live
lake
over there.
Lake Michigan and Arkansas is like right above Texas, and Lake Michigan is like in Michigan.
Yeah, that's true, huh?
Come on, man. The lake was cool. Very, very like open waters, man. That shit scares the shit out of me because, you know, there's going to be like a fucking. Yeah, I don't know. You go deep enough, it's going to be a shark because, you know, it's all warm now. So
in a fucking lake?
No, I'm talking about I said open water. Oh, okay. Shark. You know, well, I meant the ocean, you know, slash the sea. lakes are not, they are open waters too, but the like rivers fucking, you know, they just like, you know, come on in and leave. But open waters, man, you know, I think of ocean.
Yeah, I'm scared of the ocean too.
Dude, you fucking like go in and you can't even see what's under you. In the lake you can. Well, at least the lake I went to, you can.
Ever been to Lake Elsinore?
That dirty ass lake.
Oh, it's just so nasty.
Damn, that's fucking gross. I just thinking about it, because it's a closed lake, you know? So, like, all the fucking...
There's, like, dead fish belly
there's
up.
There's dead fish. There's shit. People take a shit and piss all over it. You know, everyone... All right, come on. Everyone's pissed in a pool, in a river, in an ocean.
Oh, right, I have to do it every time I go.
I don't know if I have to do it, but you just do it, because you don't want to, you know, if you're at the beach, you don't want to walk all the way to the fucking...
Where the
concrete's at and take a leak. You know, you just like, fuck, I'm going to take a piss, right? All the salt water. If you're at a, you know, so...
Have you ever taken a shit in the ocean?
No. How am I going to... All right, first of all, if you do... People who have taken a shit, how do you wipe your ass?
If you take some salt water. I don't know, man. All
right.
You haven't.
I haven't taken a shit at the fucking river. That's a mandatory. At least for me, it is. I mean, there's people out there. Oh, you want to know something funny? My brother, he goes to the what the fuck's it called? The Jones Center?
No, YMCA?
The YMCA. And I went to go pick him up at school at the YMCA yesterday, and they were already out. Usually when I go, they're still swimming, and then it takes like 10 minutes for them to get ready and put on dry clothes. And I went yesterday, and they were already ready, and I was like, oh, that's weird, you know. And they're like, hey, brother, someone took a dump in the pool. Someone took a dump in the pool. I started laughing, and I was like, and I started laughing. I told them, I was like, what was it, like diarrhea or like a log, you know? Which, if it was a log, I mean, you got to be like naked, because then it floats up, right?
Yeah.
If it's a log, well, if you're wearing shorts and it's a log, then it stays in your pants or whatever. I don't know. So I assume it was diarrhea, and I started laughing because they told me all the kids had to clear the pool, and... I was laughing on the way home just because they kept talking about, you know how kids are. They say the same shit like 10 times, and you're like, yeah, that's up.
That is funny. I could only imagine the kids just yelling, ah, there's a turd. I wonder if it was a floater. Maybe it was I don't know.
Yeah, no, I'm assuming it was diarrhea. You know kids, too. They get diarrhea. And everything. I don't know. So.
You know what? I think I've been to that YMCA. Is it the one down that way? When I was small.
Sorry about that. I took a drink.
No, you didn't.
Cheers. Everybody cheers. These Coors are putting in work.
You know what's weird?
Not the Coors Light. Coors.
When it's I was small, I went to that YMCA.
It's the one on Edison.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's the one. Yeah. I don't want to say the place, but...
It's just Edison. That's all it is. Edison.
So then I was small, right? And I went to that place, and I learned how to snap my fingers inside of the pool.
You sure it wasn't inside the locker room?
No, it was in the pool. I was like, what the fuck? I was small. My fingers were pruny. I was like, oh, shit. I don't know. I just thought it was weird.
I remember going there and I don't...
Oh, you know what's nasty? I remember seeing an old man dick in there. This guy just fucking like, oh, it's like old-ass people don't give a shit. They just fucking let it hang.
You know, I think after... I don't know. I mean, like I'll... In the locker room, I mean, I'll take off, you know, my pants and... Not by boxers, but just, you know, switch clothes, right? So that's normal, but I don't know about dick.
Yeah, dude, but fucking, they're just in there having a conversation. Like, hey, what up, Bill?
Imagine people who, you know, when you're in football and you have to take showers together, you know, and it's just funny because I had a friend who used to pop lock and drop it. I swear.
In the shower?
In the shower with the whole football team, and I started laughing because, you know, just, you know, you pop lock and drop it. And then your balls and your dick are just hanging just down.
California clap.
You know, bam. And just fucking... And it's just funny because... And I say it's true because, you know, he told me. And then the other football players told me. It was nothing gay. It was just hilarious. You know, he's not gay or anything. It was just fucking funny. And
there was no homo called or what?
And you could just imagine, you know, like, you know, one of your bros or whatever just pop, lock, and drop it in the shower. You know, this is like fucking, what is this? Junior high, you know? It's back in like fucking junior high. It's just funny when you think about it. It's just shit.
It had to be junior high. It's pop, lock, and drop it. That song hasn't been relevant in fucking years.
I mean, it's just something back in the day. It's just funny. You know, we all do dumb shit when, you know, back in high
school. Pop, lock, and drop it.
We still do dumb shit now, but,
I didn't have to shower with dudes when I was in football.
Oh, that's very interesting.
Yeah.
It's like, I mean, it's fucking Thursday and we're just fucking, it's Thirsty Thursday, you know, Thirsty. Cheers, everybody. And You just chilling in my backyard. Fucking drinking a beer. Yes. You know, how you guys doing? How's your guys' day?
Pause for response.
Anybody have a good day? Anyone have a bad day? You know, someone got dumped today. Someone got fucking got blowed today. Someone got eaten out today.
Someone died today. Ooh.
Died. That baby's born today.
Every 8 seconds, a baby is born. Who gives a shit? Something like that.
There's so many people in the world, and so many kids are still being born. You know, fuck it, right?
Yeah, dude, man. How many billions of motherfuckers are there on Earth?
Mexicans just putting them out, man. Fucking no condom, no birth control, just balls to the wall.
That's how we do it. That's my race right there.
And then you wonder, you know, I'm just playing. No, but for real, it's Mexicans, you know.
Hey, man, stop hating on Mexicans. I'm Mexican.
So, fucking.
We run this country, dog.
Yeah, no, Chinese run this country.
No, they don't. Actually, Chinese run China. Americans run this country.
Not even. Who runs this country?
Obama?
It certainly is not the government, I'll tell you that. I mean, they run it, but they run it as much as, like, it's like a gang, you know what I mean? But then again, you know, coming back to the whole, like, spying thing, you know, then again, there's not a lot of other countries that have the freedom, like, we have the freedom, like, you can't go to Russia, or you can't go to fucking China and be like, oh, I'm gonna become a skateboarder, mom, and then, you know, or, oh, I'm gonna become an artist. I mean, you can, you know what I mean, but it's so difficult, because it's, like, tradition and all that shit, but in America, You really just do
a lot of opportunity.
That's why there's so many lazy people. You know, there's a lot of lazy people. Yeah. You know, there's people who just chill. I mean, that's fine. I mean, I chill too. But I mean, I'm talking about the fucking losers who don't like to do anything. And especially the younger generation. Like, I don't even know what generation we are, but I'm fucking 22. And I'm talking about like 16, 17, 18 year olds. And I see them in school or wherever the fuck, a store. And it's so different. It's like, what the fuck? And then I'm sure that's what people who
that's
are like...
That's how it is, man.
I'm sure that's what people who are 25, 26 think of us, 22, 23-year-olds.
When we were that age, you know, the older people were
but
like...
But it's different. Technology, people are dumb. No, excuse me. People are getting dumber, lazier, less creative. You know, there's still some. And I'm not... Obviously, there's not everybody. But that's just how it is. And you can imagine how shit will change over the next few years. And it's just a lot of shit, really. And only in America, you know, and then, but you go to other countries and it's a lot different, you know, like the whole, you go to another country and you don't feel the same thing, like stress, you know, stress wise is totally different in other countries than here, you know, everything's just different. I'll say that. But damn.
Yeah, I'm sure a lot of places are different, pretty sure, because, you know, some people are, they don't have a lot of the technology. They just know what they see, you know? It's just whatever's around them. You live in a fucking farm where your whole family grows corn, then you're going to be a fucking corn farmer.
They're more...
simple as that.
Traditional and more basic and more simple. You know, not as in everybody, but they're just, you know, in the United States, there's more of, like, the whole American dream has changed, this whole fucking... you know, the ideal back in the day was, like, move out when you're 18, you know, have your own car, or even before that, have your own job, go to school, and just do all that, and just, you know, the guy takes care of the chick.
Oh.
But nowadays, it's totally different. Like, you know, people are living with their parents. It's just financial, all right? It's not like, it's also financial. Don't think it's because people are lazy, but financially, it's just how it is, too. Fucking economy. That's what bankers and all...
Yeah,
fucking Bill.
It's just a lot.
Shout out to Bill Burr.
It's a lot more difficult to get the bankers, your own home.
You know, they
stuff like that.
Yeah, exactly. It is true. You know, and that's what happens. You know, when you think about it, I was just thinking about this the other day, and I was driving to work, and I said bankruptcy only starts at $200, and I'm sure it goes up to a couple grand. I forget, but let's just say you owe, like, why do you go to bankruptcy? It's because you can't pay your bills. I mean, you can't pay your debt. And you can't do it. All right, so let's say you own like $10,000 in debt. All right, you owe somebody $10,000. You owe, let's just keep it simple. You owe a friend $10,000, whatever. And then there's another friend who's like, hey, man, I'll let him go, you know, for $200. So you pay this other friend $200, and the other guy tells your other friend, hey, don't worry about that $10,000. But you still somehow spent $10,000 to do whatever you did. Someone's out of those 10,000.
Someone got boned.
Exactly. So, and then you're like, oh, and where did that money go? No one's gonna pay it back because bankruptcy takes care of it. And then it's just like, there goes 10,000. All right, that's just one person. But we're not, you know, in a country of, I don't know how many people. I mean, in the United States, I don't know how many people in the United States. But you know, that's just how it goes. So you owe 100,000, you pay 10,000. What happened to the other 90? You know, you don't pay the other 90, et cetera, et cetera.
So sound that's like a scam, sir.
Then you wonder why we're in this financial situation. Then George Bush, the whole Iraqi war, weapons of mass destruction.
That's a whole another story.
That's another story.
You know that we're so much in debt that all the money in the world, if like collected it together and try to pay it off, like it wouldn't, you'd still be in debt.
See,
America, land of the debt.
Exactly. You know, and then you know we try. That's our country as our debt, and then we're in debt too. You know, am I in debt? I owe a couple hundred dollars. Am I proud of it? No. Am I fucking tired of it? Yes. Am I working for it? Yeah. Fuck, that sucks ass.
That's a horrible feeling, knowing that you owe people money.
You know, that's true. You know what I mean? But what can you, you know, that's just how, you just pay the interest, or you pay the principal, whatever, both. And then it's just how it is. Oh, well, hold on. Let me get started on this new beer, this ice cold beer. And yes, I have to work tonight. That's how responsible I am. There it is. Cheers again.
Another one.
Oh, whoops. Hold on. Cheers.
Cheers.
For sure.
Talking about fucking debt. Shit is boring. Boring.
Shut up and drink your beer.
Oh, you shut your mouth. How about we take a little break and play a little game called Who Tweeted It? All right, Juan, here's how this game works. I'm going to read you a tweet. For sure. You have to guess who said it. And I'm going to give you a list of people, okay?
All right.
All right, the tweet is, I wonder if Da Vinci made duck lips while he painted his selfies. Who said this?
Stupid. That's a
Oprah woman. Oprah Winfrey?
That's a woman. Oh, shit.
Who said this? Oprah Winfrey?
I told you how to be a woman. Cause guys,
Seth Rogen? Guys, let me fucking listen. Guys, Seth Rogen?
Seth Rogen? That's the guy from Knocked Up?
Green? What's it? Seth Green?
Seth Green. Who the fuck is...
Or Seth MacFarlane.
Oh, it's a guy. Oh, shit.
Who said this?
Well, now that you
want me to reread it for you?
Duck lips, Da Vinci, selfie.
Okay.
I'm going to just say, I don't know who Seth Green is. Seth Green is the guy who...
The guy that made a robot chicken. Robot chicken.
I'm going to just say Seth Green.
Seth Green? Cool. That's wrong. Seth MacFarlane. The creator of Family Guy said this.
I remember from Seth MacFarlane is how he did the Grammys, or he did like the VMAs or something.
Yeah, he's
like,
fucking sucked, huh?
Like 2 years ago or whatever, and he bombed it. He tried to be funny, he wasn't funny, and everyone was like, dude, that was, and he even at the end he said he will never do the Grammys again because he sucked so bad. Can you imagine if someone asks you to do something and you suck so bad that you know it, and then like, please don't do it again. You
just quit.
And you just like, okay, I'm gonna go back to doing what I know, which is Family Guy, the creator of Family Guy, and a few other shows. I don't know. I don't think he's funny.
That show is awesome. He does like half of the voices.
He does. I prefer South Park over Family Guy. Man. You know, I prefer.
They're both funny.
They're both pretty funny, but South Park. But Family Guy, like, I kind of got tired of it, probably because I grew up more watching Family Guy, because I guess in the beginning I thought it was more of a cartoon, like a kid's cartoon, and I was like, oh, this is not a kid cartoon.
Mm-hmm.
And then South Park was actually more like adult, like way more adult-ish. I don't know. At least their newer episodes are. Yeah. Their newer episodes, like starting season 10, even though there's like 19 seasons now. So starting from like around that time, they're just bad, man. They're like bad as in good, and then bad as in like, dude, that's like, you don't want your fucking 10-year-old brother or cousin watching that shit, because they're bad, you know. Yeah. But they're fucking funny, man.
They're always the first to
yeah,
do it.
Yeah, fucking, they push it. It's so good. I'm going to turn the light real quick.
Yeah, I wonder if he's ever banged Mila Kunis, Seth MacFarlane. That'd be cool if he did. I want to bang Mila Kunis. But anyways.
You're fat.
Bitch ass. Yeah, South Park, they always are always the first to do everything. And it's always funny. I don't know if you guys ever read the beginning right before the show starts. It says all characters are fictional and I don't know what, blah, blah, blah. But at the very end it says this show should not be viewed by anyone. And then the show starts. I thought that was hilarious.
Jeez, I'm fucking hungry. Again.
Bad boy.
I know. Jeez, I don't work tomorrow. Tomorrow's the weekend. Well, at least for me it is, because I don't work. And then I work Saturday. But,
you work tonight, huh?
I do work tonight.
You're gonna be buzzing it at work.
I'm gonna fucking eat before I go to work so I can come down. I get paid tomorrow. I gotta pay all this shit, which is annoying as fuck. But it's alright. It's how it is.
Money. That's what money's for, to pay shit.
You don't even... And how Bill Burr says, you never even get the money. It's not even a value. It's just a paycheck. I mean, it's just... It's not even paper. Well, at least for... You know what I mean? Like,
it goes straight to your bank.
It goes straight to your bank, which are owned by the bankers. And then they lend out your money, and then they get double the money back, but it's only worth one time to you. But you know what I mean? Like, that's only in America. The whole monopoly.
They got their scheme going.
Yeah.
It's, like, in L.A., the fucking Citibank is, like, the tallest building.
I don't know about
that. I don't know. You haven't been to L.A.?
Oh, my God. I've been to L.A. I probably just don't pay attention to that.
It's the R2-D2 building. Looks like R2-D2
is the only building I know in L.A. at the moment is actually the Ritz-Carlton Hotel, which is just number one brand of hotels. And it's right next to the Staples Center. It's fucking... I can just imagine... Eventually, I'll go there and check it out, but it's just a very cool hotel. Jeez. Number one luxury brand in the world.
Really?
Yeah.
So you go in there and everything's fucking made of gold, or what? What do you mean?
Sorry, people. I know. This is what I have to deal with. It's luxury. It's just luxury. You know, anything and everything you want is at the hotel, more or less. No, I can imagine. Like, there's no limit. Because I mean, well, what do you want? Like, right when you go, let's say you're a celebrity.
Have you been to this place?
No, I've never been to this place. I hear great. It's the number one luxury hotel in the world. So you think of luxury, you think of great, you think of good things. So you. Your average room costs from $500 to $1,000 a night. That's just your basic room versus, you know, you got like 5 different room to 10 different, to 20 different room types. No, I like 10. I don't know about 20, but 10. And then you got like just it's the quality, it's the material, it's the service, you know, it's the environment, you know what I mean? You're not dealing with a fucking Motel 6, you're going through a whole other atmosphere. You know, it's what you,
in America, got like doorman and stuff?
Exactly. In America, it's what you get what you pay for.
So I'm going to have an America counter. See how many times I say America on this fucking podcast.
So that's exactly what it is. America, like, they have their service. Like, you're like, hey, I need a Lamborghini right now. And they'll call somebody up. They'll make the move for you.
Damn.
And be like, here it is. And they'll pull it up. Yeah, I mean, and that's just one thing. I mean, can you imagine, like, the food? Like, they got... top-notch chef, so you're like, hey, I want a fucking, I don't know, pizza, right? A pizza with whatever the fuck you want on it, and they'll make it for you. As in your average hotel, they'll just be like, hey, we only make steaks and burgers and all this other shit, versus I'll cook whatever the fuck you want. Stuff like that, you know?
They got money, they can do that
shit. Yeah, exactly, it's exactly what you get paid. You get what you pay for.
Exactly. Oh. I just want to give a quick shout out to my buddy Ricky. I want to say I know he's one of our viewers, the only viewer.
We have 46 viewers on our other one. 46 people. We don't even have that many friends.
I want to say congratulations to him. He recently got married.
Oh, he did, huh?
Yeah, he got civil, huh?
Worst fucking this.
Nah, don't say that.
JK.
Congratulations.
Yeah, congratulations.
Yeah, dude. What else? Bob's in Japan now.
Just fucking don't have a kid, man. No. That's it. Ricky. I mean, whatever his nickname. Ricky, don't have a kid. God damn it.
Hey, all man, right. Stuff happens, man.
Yeah, but you gotta prevent shit like that, man. Because then you got child support, you know. Because you think of the worst just in case. So you got child support, and then you got all this other shit. No, did you know it's not called child support now? It's called family support. And you know how child support was only till you were 18?
Yeah.
Now, family support is until the chick marries again. like alimony. Like alimony and child support were different things. Alimony was you pay the wife X amount of dollars, and child support was you pay the whatever. I mean, you give their money until the kids are 18, because that's assuming when you can take care of. I mean, that's when the kid can take care of himself. All right, now I just found this out like a few weeks ago. At least in California, I don't know about anywhere else. All right, they're together. Like they were two separate things. Now now just in general, it's called family support. So, I mean, your kids can be fucking 25, and the wife will still be getting like fucking X amount of dollars, and your kids are already working doing this until she gets married again. Think about it. If you're married and then you got divorced, and whoever, a guy or girl, is paying you, usually the guy is paying because the chicks always win, are paying giving you $2,000 a month, because that's just how it is. Are you gonna remarry again? Like, can you imagine?
Probably not.
Like, you're gonna date somebody that's like, hey, you know, let's not get married because my ex-husband is giving me two, or wife is giving me $2,000 a month. Like, are you gonna do it? Right? No, probably not. But you're gonna like live together and do all that shit. But like I said, it doesn't matter the dollar amount. But I mean, that's what it's called now. It's not called child support. It's called family support, and that shit's forever. Once again, until you get married again.
Well, that's horrible.
So Ricky.
But I'm sure Ricky is gonna live happily ever after.
Be careful. Okay. And Bob, shout out to Bob. We miss Bob.
Yeah.
Dearly.
We miss you, Bob.
Bob right now is in Japan. I don't know what the fuck that was.
That's me crying, fake crying.
Okay. And Bob right now is in Japan. He IM'd me on Facebook earlier, and he said he was bored as shit. And I told Bob, he said he'll be back here in like April, March, something like that, of the spring of next year. So, you know, it's only a few months away, Bob. You know, don't worry.
For those who don't know, Bob is one of our dear friends that is in the Marines. He came down for a month. Ish.
He did. He sure
and,
did.
And he's back over there now, and he's doing his thing. He has a couple more years to serve.
And I keep telling Bob, get that clam from the Japanese.
Oh, the Japanese clam?
The Japanese twat.
Mmm.
I've yet to get it myself, you know, but...
probably tastes like oysters.
It probably has some hair. All right. This for Bob, right here.
What is that?
AC/DC.
AC/DC?
Yeah.
Dude, we're gonna get flagged. Get some shit out of here.
Oh, no, I mean DC, AC.
No, dude, the fucking sound waves.
Oh.
Sorry, Bob. We'll link you to the other page.
Yeah, we will. Bob, but you got to get that clam, all right, for all of us. Tell us how it is.
Hey, that was cool when we kicked it at his house, remember?
It sure was. I haven't seen Bob in a year, and we had some carne asada.
We went to his brother's house, isn't it?
His brother's house.
Or his dad's house?
No, it was his brother with the pool.
Hey, the house is fucking cool, man.
It was really cool.
He has like a 1920s Coca-Cola machine or whatever. It's like super old.
He had a fucking casino machine in there, bitch.
He had a slot machine.
Yep. Or a slot machine, sorry.
He had a pool.
Had a big ass grill.
Sick ass grill.
It was cool. Cool environment.
And then it was just us, and we were just like being ourselves, you know, being clowns.
Bros before hoes, you know what I mean? Because that's how it is. And
how many beers did you drink? I drank so many beers.
I think I drank a good, I'm going to say like 7. I must just say 10.
Too many.
Like 9 or 10, you know. I'm only one fucking 65. 165, you know.
A dozen and a half.
Oh.
And remember,
we were eating, you know, we were drinking beer and eating at the same time, so it kind of like cancels out.
Yeah.
So, but.
I mean, we're there for a few hours. It wasn't like 10 straight beers.
Yeah. I know, right? And like.
It just, you know, they just give me another one. You guys want another one? And it just adds up, you know.
Yeah, so we miss you, Bob. So we'll see you soon. Putting in work for the Air Force. I mean, I'm an idiot.
Oh, he's gonna smack you. He's gonna smack shit out of you.
I don't know why I said Air Force.
He's a Marine.
Yeah, Devil Dog.
Yeah, he's a Devil Dog. He's a Jarhead, or is that what they call him nowadays?
I think Jarhead's Army.
Is it?
I'm pretty sure, but I could be wrong. I'm an idiot. I'm very sure. We'll look it up after this. I'll look it up right now. Hold
bum, 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 bum.
Jarhead. Hold on. That's Jesus Walks.
Jesus?
Jar.
He's a part of Jesus' army. Yeah. He introduced us to this Japanese drink. What was it?
I don't know. It's in my closet right
you
now.
You have his stuff?
Yeah.
Stuff was good, dude.
I'm gonna fucking drink it. Fuck you.
It was like a...
Oh, it is a Marine.
Rice. Yeah. It was like a rice wine.
No, actually.
It wasn't sake, though. And he mixed it with like a mango juice.
He said you can mix it with anything, though. Jarhead was... let's see.
Have you ever seen that movie Jarhead?
U.S. Army, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, I mean Marine. Sorry. Yeah, it's about Marines. You're all right.
That fucking,
No, I haven't seen that movie. I'm not a big military movie person. I'm more of a... I like decent movies. Well, Saving Private Ryan.
Oh, that's a great one. That's a classic.
Hurt Locker. What was it? What was another Army movie?
Saving Private Ryan.
I said that one.
Did you read,
Pearl Harbor.
What's that? Full Metal Jacket?
Oh, that's a good one. You like dicks?
That's the only... I only watched that movie till the fucking boot camp part. After that, it's like, eh.
It was alright. It was cool. The sniper scene was cool. The sniper scene. There's another one. There has to be another one.
Black Hawk Down.
Black Hawk. I've seen that one. That's a really good one.
It's all very gory.
It really is.
It's very gory. And then, like, I asked my friend about how it is over there, and he's like, "Oh, it's a lot of hurry up and wait. Just pretty much waiting for whatever, you know."
What else?
So it's not what the movies make it seem.
I'm thinking of one more.
Would you ever sign up for something like that?
You know, back in the day when I was in high school in like 10th and 11th grade, they were like, "Oh, sign up for us, we'll give you a $5,000 bonus."
Yeah, they really try to brainwash you when you're in high school.
Well, they really want you to go, and they had all these bonuses and shit, and they're like, "We'll pay for school, you know." And that's cool, but now when you sign up, because there's so many people, they don't give you shit. It's just like you're just signing up for a job, and then 4 years later, you know, how about this? What's a good question?
Branch?
Yeah, well, there you go. What branch would you join?
If I were to join a branch, I would try for Air Force.
Right, everyone wants to try for Air Force because that one's, like, supposedly the better one and the smarter one, yeah, which is fine.
I don't know. I mean, we never been to it.
Would it be Marine? Marines are going to be like, "Oh, you can't be a Marine because, you know, whatever."
You got to be, like, a super badass to be a Marine.
You know what? I'm not even going to say anything because I know people are going to get mad. And do I hate Marines? No, they're all tied together.
Everyone's in the same team.
They have their own specific tasks. Okay.
Yeah.
Like Navy is all what Marines. Well, I don't. No, I'm not gonna say that. Navy takes care of the ocean. All right. Navy takes care of the ocean. Air Force takes care of the air. Army's kind of like a little bit of general. And Marines, like, all upfront soldier. You know what I mean? And that's all how it is, all right?
Yeah, everyone has their specialty.
Exactly.
And everyone thinks they're the best.
I mean,
if you're in a certain branch, of course you're going to be like, "Oh, well, my branch is the shit," because you're in that branch.
It makes sense, all right? So what would I choose? I like the sea, you know, just general. Like, I like the ocean and sea, so I'd probably say Navy. "You're going to be a seaman."
"You're going to be a seaman?"
You know,
I like to fly a jet. That'd be awesome.
Yeah, that would be cool. So I'd probably be in Navy. I didn't want to join the Navy a long time ago because they travel the world, all right, and more, on the sea. But then I think of being, like, in a submarine, and I'm like, if that bitch got attacked and we're, like...
Oh, you'd be fucked, huh?
All these miles down the ocean, you wouldn't even have a chance because you'd just be dead. I was like, "Oh, I don't know about that." So I probably might go to the Army. You know what I mean? The Army would be cool.
I wonder if you'd ever, like, if you get, like, seasick if you're on one of those big-ass boats.
You wouldn't even feel it. It's so big. It was so big.
One of those boats that carry all those fucking airplanes?
You know, if you have a little boat, you're going to be, like, you know, jumping and hopping around. But if it's a big-ass boat, it's just the size of it. You wouldn't really feel too much. I mean, you know what I mean?
All right, scenario. Look, you're inside of a submarine 40,000 leagues under the sea.
Anyways.
A fucking hole punches in your shit. And your fucking submarine slowly gets crushed from the pressure. Like,
what am I gonna do?
Yeah, dude. Like, there's not much you can do. That's crazy, huh?
No, exactly, right. You're already calling it. You're done.
Fuck, it's so crazy, dude. Ugh, I don't even want to think about that. You probably. Nah, it's not. But yeah, we miss you, Bob.
Ricky, don't have a kid, please.
Nah, dude. Telling Ricky's smart, man. He's not. He knows what he's doing.
Yes.
All
right, Ricky's smart, you know, but the dick has no brain. The dick, it just...
All the blood goes to the dick and your brain
just... Sometimes the dick, the dick just takes over. And you're like, "I don't give a fuck." The dick just wants the clam.
The clam chowder. You
know, that's it. It's selfish. And that's how it is. Ladies.
Even if he was to have a kid, I know Ricky would be a good father. Because I know him personally.
Oh, I.
He would do everything in his power to give him the best, him or her, the best life that he can.
I think it's like every parent's.
Yeah.
Major. That's what every parent wants. But does it happen every time? No. But yeah. I think I agree.
He's very ambitious. Very, very ambitious.
So yeah, watch out. What's his girlfriend's
Congrats. Name? Candy? Don't say don't say names, man. This Ricky's cool because he's in the he's in the scandal.
Oh,
scandal
yeah.
Scandal P.
Yeah.
Dude, it's always just us two. Jonathan was supposed to be on the podcast, but he's at work.
He said he actually just got off 5 minutes ago. I don't know if he wants to come.
Well, he texted me right before we started, told us to start without him. So, yeah, we did. Jonathan's funny, man. He's just freaking hilarious.
Dude, Jonathan is actually very funny.
He would have said something funny, and we would have been just laughing, cracking up.
You know, I'm already ready for Taco Bell. TB.
TB? Tabriki Locus?
Stupid.
Fuck that one up, huh? This guy texted me earlier, and he was like, TB? And I'm like, what? You got tuberculosis? And he's like, Taco Bell, dude. The fuck? And this is weird. So then we went, got some food, came back over here, chilled for a minute, got some beers, and we're like, hey, dude, we haven't done a podcast in, what, like a month?
Yeah, something like that.
Dude, it's fucking too long. So yeah, now we're doing it. You know, I'm talking about dumb stuff and stuff that don't matter.
Oh.
Dude, you look so funny right now.
Why?
You're all fidgeting and you're like blah, burping and.
Fuck.
Are you drunk?
No. Anyways, work's gonna be interesting. Not because I'm buzzing it, but just because I usually sleep before work and then I go to work, and I'm just even though I take a nap before work, I'm still tired at work. I don't know, right? Some power nap that is. Yeah. I take like a two hour power nap, and I'm still tired at work.
Right? Well, you go to sleep at work?
No, that's bad.
Yeah, it's fucking. That'd be cool if that was your job.
I said I take a nap before work. Yeah. So tonight should be cool. I mean, I don't work tomorrow, so. Tomorrow's gonna be a good day. It's one of my coworker's birthday, so we're gonna get her like this cookie cake.
Oh, you know, those are good.
I hear those are good, and I'm actually looking forward to that. You know, shout out. I won't say her name, but that's cool. That's on her. How old is she gonna be? 20? Yeah, but she's still like 15, so it's. So.
In your mind.
In her mind, shit. So she's gonna get me and my other coworker are gonna. I think I'm gonna buy the pizzas, and she's gonna buy the cake, the cookie cake, and I swear to God, I'm gonna have a fucking glass of milk with that cake. All right.
Oh, it's gonna be good.
Fuck yeah.
Especially if it's fresh.
And you know what's funny? That cake serves for 12 people. I kid you not. There's gonna be like 5 people there. All right. It's gonna be like me, my boss, my coworker's birthday, and that's it. And maybe a few people who walk in on us, and they're like, oh, can I, and you know, you don't want to be an asshole, so you're like, hey, you want a piece of cake? You know, but more or less, I'm going to get a good piece of cake.
You're going to get like a fucking big-ass cube of cake?
I fucking love cookies. Chocolate chip cookies at that.
Ever tried like cookies, fresh baked cookies with some ice cream on top?
Albertsons has good fucking cookies. Yeah. All right. Who else? Portos. There you go.
Portos.
Not Portos. I mean, yeah. They have good cookies too. There's only a few here in California. Who else has good? Famous something. They're in that kind of tannish bag. I have a bag in the house, which actually I'm gonna go eat right now.
Here, dude, remember those fucking cupcakes you took me to? Those were so good.
That sounds so gay, but yeah, remember? I did. Those are fucking good too. Those are $3.50 a piece.
Those fucking cupcakes are the shit.
Yeah, I haven't had those cookies in a long time because that's more of a like, you want to, you know, like. Take your girl to get a cup. I wouldn't wake up and be like, you know what, I'm gonna have a cupcake today. And then you drive your.
I mean, we're
ass.
Driving by and we're like, hey, dude, there's a fucking cupcake
yeah,
place
are,
right
those
here.
Those are fucking good.
And we went and it was
have,
fucking
they
good.
They have different flavors, like seasonal flavors and shit. And they, you know, but your average flavors are good as well. But damn, $3.50.
Remember the girl that was in there? She was hot.
Oh, she was good looking. I haven't been there in a few months. So, but yeah, I remember she was good looking.
I haven't been there since the first time we went. I had that red velvet one. Ooh, that shit was good. I remember seeing like a fucking bacon one. I was like, ah, oh, come on, you can't just fucking throw bacon on everything. What's wrong with you guys?
That shit was a breakfast.
Did you try that bacon one?
I tried it. It was a breakfast. It was like a breakfast cupcake. It's like a fucking pancake in a cupcake, with syrup in the center with bacon sprinkles on top.
Bacon sprinkles?
And it has, I don't remember. It's called, what is it called again? Anyone who lives in California, it's called My Delight Cupcakery. It's on the 10 freeway and on Mountain. It's not open on Sundays.
Yeah, you know the schedule and shit?
I remember. It's like Monday through Friday or Saturday, it's open from like 10 or 11 to like 5, 6 or 7. But the thing is that they're so good, they sell out before they close. And they always post it on Facebook to say that they sold out. So, you know, if it's like 5, 4, 5, 6 or 7, you probably want to call and be like, make sure that they still have certain flavors, because they just sell out. You know, it's so good.
I remember going and they were like, oh, we don't make the cupcakes here. Like, what the hell? How does that work?
Oh, that's, yeah. I guess a truck brings them in or some shit like that. But I've been in there and they're like, oh, we're making some right now. I've seen them because they have all that equipment in the back. If you look, whenever you go, you look in the back and they have all the bakery shit, you know? And I'm like, oh, okay, for sure. But I could care less, really. I mean, I don't ask where my Taco Bell taco's made, you know? It's made in the back, but where's the meat made? I don't know. Fuck, they get sent to the Taco Bell.
That's some true. Shit.
And it's a cupcake.
It's that grade F pink slime, dude.
What's good, Horn? I'm In-N-Out?
Oh, nah. I had In-N-Out yesterday, man. That shit was good. It's the grilled onions, bro.
Anyways.
It's good. That's what makes it. It gives that pop.
Pizza Hut, you down?
They give it the. They put mustard on their meat too.
You down for Domino's?
Right now?
I'll fucking. I got the app for it.
Oh, sick, for dude! Sure. Technology is so badass.
Technology is cool, but it makes us less creative. I'll use the money that we got. That we, yeah, for sure.
Dude,
right?
Fucking badass.
So Domino's Monday through Thursday, they got a.
this is not a sponsored video, by the way.
It's not. But I'm just letting
we
you guys know.
We just love Domino's. We love
food. Domino's is good. All right, if you want
garlic crust, all that.
If you want flavor, you go to Domino's. If you want crust, because you know that's the majority of the pizza. Actually, you know what? Pizza sounds pretty good right now.
They have a special going on too. I seen the commercial.
It's $6.99 for one topping, but I kind of want stuffed crust. What do you think?
From Pizza Hut?
Yeah.
I mean, it's... Yeah, fuck it. Stuffed crust. You're going to put cheese in it, right? Or what else do they stuff it with? Do we have a choice?
But the last time I had stuffed crust, it was aight. You know what I mean? It was aight.
I remember I had stuffed crust one time, and it was, like, fucking, like, beyond cheesy.
Yeah, no, I've had stuffed crust, too, and I was like, oh, all right, this is a... I only ate, like, one slice, because I was like, oh, this is just too much for me.
It's like, ooh...
It's like...
Yeah, dude, order that shit. That's gonna be tight.
Pizza Hut, for sure. But Domino's...
ever since they made that the new recipe a long time ago?
Yeah, they Domino's upped their game.
Hell yeah, straight. They did.
And you know what's funny is that Domino's had this special for a decent minute, and then all of a sudden, all these people had it too. So, is it on Mount A?
Yeah, dude, they had a... It's called Build a Fan Base... So they lowered their prices real low, and then when they got you hooked, they fucking raise it a couple of dollars. And that's how it is. That's how you make a good business moves. Are you calling them right now?
Yeah, I'm calling right now.
Alright. So we're gonna get some pizza.
Pizza?
So we ended already?
I didn't take a leak. Nah.
Alright.
All right. I don't know why Sammy stopped it. I told him not to stop it, but Domino's doesn't do. Usually, you'll call and you could add the stuffed crust for $2 more for whatever you do. But in this one, you can't. I'm getting a Domino's, which I'm using the app for, which is actually fucking hella cool. Let's see. Meats, pepperoni, sausage. All right, bitches. Actually, whoops. Extra pepperoni.
Back.
And Italian sausage. Save toppings. Let's see. Hold on. Add to coupon.
All right. So we called
Domino's. Done.
Pizza Hut.
Now we call.
And they said that we couldn't stuff our crust. Fuck them.
I don't know, Pizza.
How do they deny us our stuffed crust privileges?
863. Check out. No, I would not like breadsticks.
They try to sell you breadsticks.
Check out.
Wow. Yeah, so we're ordering pizza right now, I guess. We're gonna have my lunch. This should be interesting. So we're ordering pizza while we're doing the podcast. Not talking about much, but yeah.
You know, your order will be available for tracking momentarily. Would you like to open the tracker view now?
Dude, you know what's bullshit? I downloaded the app. At my house, it doesn't work. Like, if I put in my address, they'll be like, oh, we do not deliver to this address. Like,
You have to choose carryout. Oh, maybe they don't deliver to your house. I don't know.
It's fucked up. They live like 2 blocks away.
Yeah, they don't deliver. I always pick it up. Because, yeah, dude, to deliver to your house, they charge you like $2 or $3 more. I mean, you might as well just fucking go up the street and pick it up yourself.
That's true.
I mean, that's me, though. But then again, I have a car. I don't know about you.
I mean, I can go get it. You can drive it.
Let's see.
But fuck that.
Delivery. What's the movie? Oh, I want to see. I was watching, you know what I saw? What's her name? The bitch from Teen Mom?
Farrah.
Abraham?
Yeah, there you go.
Saw her porno.
Oh, dude, she's hot.
She is hot. But I'm going to tell you something. Her twat is not hot.
You don't like her twat?
Her twat is not hot.
She got like a loose labia or what?
Yeah, something like that, you know.
Dude, that hit that shit. She got fake titties on. She does
have fake titties.
Those are all brown.
Someone told me that she actually is a good mom. Really? But then I'm like, dude, your son's gonna grow up to be like 20, and he's gonna be like, hey mom, what's this porno? You know, and then he's like, and then in her porno, she's like,
James Dean fucking rails the shit out of her.
She's like, fuck my pussy.
And he puts it in her butt.
Oh, he puts it in her butt too. Like that's too funny.
And then she squirts.
And then she from squirt, anal. Yeah. She squirts her J. You can't squirt from your anal.
No, but she's getting hit through the back, and then she squirts through her J.
Whatever.
Have you seen this movie? Are we talking about the same one?
I didn't see the whole movie, but I'm just saying, like, I was like...
Did you finish before you before you got to that part?
I was like, this is...
There's, like, 3 different clips, dude. There's that, the one, the shower one.
Fucking, what are...
The one in the limo.
Would I masturbate? Would I get nailed to get paid what she got paid? She got paid, like, $200,000.
Really? I thought she got, like, $1 million.
I know her first check was like...
Vivid gave her like $1 million.
I know that her first cut check was like 150. And how do I know this? TMZ people, alright?
TMZ,
so...
Motherfuckers know everything.
They do know everything. Alright, and they're funny. I think they're funny. Some people don't think they're funny, which is cool.
Larry, is that the name of the guy?
Larry. I don't actually know.
That guy's, And they got that fucking stoner white guy.
Oh, that's the... Dude, if I knew more about celebrities and their names and all that shit, I would totally apply for that show. But I don't. Like, I don't know anything about them.
That's why you learn. Dude, like...
I mean, but there's
just... They just fucking wait at, like, fucking places where these people go, and then they follow them.
I'm not talking about the cameraman. I'm talking about, like, the... Like, in general, you know what I mean? Like they just know about, like... About these celebrities, you know? Like, I don't really give a shit, you know? If I lived in L.A., and I was always around, like, that business or that industry, yeah, I'd probably know more, but I really don't. So I could care less.
Dude, when I was going through LAX, they have this fucking entrance right before you get searched where the celebrity's going through. There was a guy with a fucking camera, but the lens was, like, fucking a foot long.
Yeah.
I was like, God damn, who the fuck's in here that's famous? I was looking around. I didn't recognize anybody.
Yeah, exactly, because there's so many people you don't know. Like, there's so many people that you... I mean, you know the people who make headlines, but you don't know the people. That's the thing. It's what I meant to say. Excuse me. The people who you don't know are the people are also the people you film and all that and ask them questions. Like, there's so many people that would walk right past me and be like, I don't know who the fuck that is, and that's the point, is that they know I don't know. That's why they get paid, and that's why they fucking do the thing they do on TMZ.
You know what's crazy? I bet you, like, if a mob would build up around somebody. Oh, it's somebody famous, and like half of those people don't know who the fuck he is.
Yeah, I don't know who they are, but I also wouldn't be a creeper.
Let me get your autograph, and then you don't know who the fuck it is. That's so fucking weird, dude. Imagine you're like Jay-Z, like you can't go to the fucking store and buy some milk. You can't fucking do shit. You can't pump your gas.
Something like that, yeah, man.
You can't step out of your house with somebody recognizing you. You can't even like talk on the phone because that's like a fucking everyone knows that voice. That's fucking nuts. Like, what's his name, Eminem says, something about he's taking a shit, and they don't let him take a shit because he's so famous. Everyone's trying to get his autograph. It's one of his, it's in one of his songs.
I don't remember, but like more or less whatever.
Scenario. Would you want to be that famous where you can't go out and you can't do shit?
I don't know about that. That's kind of annoying.
It is annoying, huh?
You know what I mean? Like,
I don't blame like Kanye how he gets mad. I mean, he has a temper and he's kind of like a dick.
He's fucking an asshole.
But I don't blame him because, you know, he can't fucking do shit.
Yeah, he
remember when he ran into that fucking pole? they put it on TMZ.
He hit it first.
I don't know what happened, but fucking
he hit it first.
What do you mean?
Like that
talking
song.
Talking about Kim?
Yeah, he hit it first.
Ah, fucking Ray J got it. But even before that, I'm sure she's been railed many times. Have you seen the Kim Kardashian porno?
Yeah, it was cool.
It's horrible. I don't like it.
Nah, it was whatever's.
That's like, I mean, she's fine and everything, don't get me wrong. But it's just the same scene replayed over and over again. And just, like, screen flipped. And she's on drugs. Her jaw's off. She's going like this, moving it side to side. Like, she's on fucking ecstasy or, like, cocaine. I'm like, what the fuck's wrong with this bitch? Is she just taking it? So weird.
Dude, this is so...
on your phone trying to do a podcast.
So what? Sometimes there's funny stuff on the phone, man. Dude, Domino's all the way.
Domino's is the shit.
No, all right, for you know, like chain restaurants, or I mean chain stores.
What's the best pizza you ever had?
The best pizza? I'm not gonna lie, Papa John's is pretty good.
Papa John's is good, but I think I've had better. You know what's always good? Like those fucking mom and pop shops.
Boston's is good. Boston's pizza place is good.
That place is all right. I had a bad experience when I went.
Was that when we went?
It was all burnt.
That was. I thought it was good. I mean, I've been there more than once. I've been there a few times, and I was like, dude, this is fucking good.
Like I bit into it, and that shit like hurt.
It's because you're fucking. I don't know.
That shit was burnt straight up.
It wasn't.
It was burnt. Cool because we had like fucking beer.
Yeah, we had a fucking. Like, I think we had, like...
And it was fresh. Like, it was it's a fresh pizza. But I just thought it... I gotta try it again. I mean, it was a bit pricey, but, you know, whatever. Good Ontario. We always have things flying over us. That's a helicopter. Yeah. How many airplanes have passed by in the past...
I'm gonna say a good five. Five airplanes have passed.
Only two. I've counted them.
The only time... The only two of them have made, like, noise. But I've seen, like, five or six...
Yeah, we're recording this in the backyard this time. The last podcast was in the in the front yard, and there was just cars all day and night.
Yeah, cars just, man, people just fucking.
We live in a fucking crowded ass place, and it's just getting more crowded. And you know how I know this is happening? Because like more shops are opening up like along fucking the main roads, and it's just gonna get more packed and more packed and more packed.
I love how Cardenas right here says it still says grand opening, but that shit opened like half a year ago. You know,
it probably cost too much money to take that fucking sign down.
Dude, it's a plastic sign.
Yeah, but
it's like nailed to the wall.
It's gonna be there till it falls out.
It says grand opening, and I'm like, dude, that shit opened like in a fucking January. Even before then, you know what I'm saying? I was like, what the fuck? I don't understand.
Maybe it's a marketing
Mexicans,
scheme.
Mexicans, you know, get your family, you know, you get your brother up there and just take off the sign.
Get a big old ladder.
It's your peoples, man. Fuck.
Hey, my peoples are tight.
Yeah, they're real tight.
Hey, man, they got some good chicken right there.
I don't know about that.
Have you tried it?
Well, what did I have from there? I have the horchata from there. I have the strawberry there. The strawberry, like, juice they had.
Yeah.
What else they have?
They have Mexican soda. Made with real sugar instead of that high fructose shit.
Oh, no shit.
It's good.
I didn't know that.
Yeah. Comes in the bottles and it says, un litro.
Stupid.
It's in Mexican. I mean, Spanish.
Dumb. I like to go to Tijuana and, like, fucking just hang out for a day there.
Party?
I don't know about party.
We should take your car and then just walk through the border.
Yeah, I've done it.
I know my way, dude.
I don't know about that, man. It's so sketchy. Because
Hey, look, have you ever been?
Oh, a long time ago with my dad.
Yeah,
we were fucking. It was like fucking. I was like, what, maybe 12? You know what I'm saying? Like,
it's not that sketchy.
Times were different back then. Mexican cartel, wink, wink. You know, like, I don't know, man, throw a grenade while you walk and shit.
As long as you're not fucking wearing a Tony Montana suit and some fucking chains and stuff like that, you'll be alright. Flashing your money. People are dumb. Like, they'll be like, oh, making it rain and shit. And people see that, you know? And those guys are poor, man. They gotta survive.
So, I don't know, man. I don't want to get fucking kidnapped. You know what I mean?
I mean, you run the risk everywhere to get kidnapped. But over there, I guess it's a little more.
Yeah, a little more. Anyway.
Whatever. You never been, so you don't know. I've been a couple times.
It's cool, dog.
It is cool.
Yeah, it's real cool.
There's this club, dude. You can go.
Yeah, this club with fat chicks.
There was a couple fat chicks, but there were some good ones, too.
Yeah, they probably work for the cartel, and they try to get you. And then when you go to the hotel room, they jack you, dog.
Oh, yeah. That's not what happened.
Because you didn't get the chicks.
Whatever, let's not mention what happened over there. What happens in TJ stays in TJ.
Anyways.
Hey, if we can get drunk with $12 over there.
I believe that shit. Is it worth getting drunk in Tijuana for $12 and get kidnapped? I don't think so.
If you get kidnapped, it's not fun.
Yeah, I got buzzing it with $4. $5, two tall cans, alright? I don't need to go drive 200 miles. No, excuse me. Yeah, because from here more or less 200 miles, which is like,
we're not going to do it randomly.
$50 in gas.
It'll be like a special occasion.
Oh, but we get drunk for $12.
It's just some new to see, you know?
It really is. And I'm not saying, but.
You can take a taxi. Taxis are cheap.
A taxi from here to Tijuana?
No, not like when you're in there, you know?
Oh, I'd imagine it is. It's probably, you give them $1 and you're like, oh, you just made my day.
Look, here's how it is. When you walk through the border, everything is just a bunch of shops.
Yeah, okay.
All the way through to the center.
Okay.
So it's not like you're walking in a sketchy ass street. And
no, I remember there. I remember it. Yeah. But I remember going and they made me fresh orange juice. That was dumb. Fresh orange juice.
Yeah.
And I think it was like 50 cents.
50
like,
cents?
Like, and I had like four of those bitches or a dollar. This was a long time ago, man. This is like 5 to 10 years, you know. And I was like, damn, 10, like, give me another one, you know?
Another one.
So I could, you know, and that just, you know, it's fucking cool. I definitely love to go. Yeah, I'd like to go. Do I feel secure if I went? I don't know. But
still. I was scared, too, first time I went. But I went with a group, and we ended up getting a hotel. It was like $40 for like a three beds in one room. It was sick. It was one of those fucking hotels that you could tell was like a fucking
Mexican cartel.
Like a hooker hotel. Like, we turned on the TV and there's just some fucking porn on there. I was like, what the hell?
That's funny.
You started laughing, you know?
That's funny. For sure. Well, everybody, we're gonna call it a night for today. It's fucking almost 9 o'clock.
How long is this park? We've been going for
like an hour.
58 minutes.
So I'm gonna go pick up this food because, you know, we gotta eat.
Gotta get some pizza. All right, so we're gonna sign off. Hope you guys have a lovely week, and we'll see you whenever we'll see you. This is the second podcast.
Fucking be safe. Don't drink and drive. All right. You guys have a fucking good weekend.
All right. Scam Production out.
Peace.
Deuces. Peace.